We have a couple of announcements to begin with before we come into our time of worship and our service. The first is that you are all invited to a beautiful, wonderful sit-down luncheon right after the service. Of course, those who have been here for a while know that that's always motivation for me to keep things short. There's a wonderful meal waiting for us in the Friendship Hall, Fellowship Hall. So everyone's invited to that if you'd like to stay. Also, our flowers this morning, these beautiful flowers were donated by our dear friend Ellen Scheibel in celebration of all of February family birthdays. And if you would like to donate flowers, they're very reasonably priced. And there is a sign-up sheet on the back wall. You have inserts in your bulletin. We are doing an Ash Wednesday service here at 6 o'clock. There will be, I'm looking for my compassion and blessings for individuals. The last time we did this was in 2020. Last year, I did an Ash Wednesday service sitting in the front seat of my car, live on Facebook, because I was on call that night. And so we do what we can, but we're delighted to be back in person this coming Wednesday night at 6. Any other announcements from anyone? Okay. Before we begin with our prelude, I would like us all to take a breath and to take a moment in silence for the events happening in Ukraine and around the world.
Look in your bulletin, where it says prelude, it's just one word,
Please say it with me.
God of all creation, you know us better than we know ourselves. You know when we doubt you, when we fill with fear. You know when we push you aside and turn our attention to earthly things. Please forgive us when we ignore you. Remind us of our need to put you first in all things, in every situation, in every moment. In Jesus' name.
Assurance of forgiveness is a responsive greeting. Hear and believe the good news. Anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. The old life is gone, and new life has begun.
We trust that we are forgiven by God's generous love. Lord, give us humility and courage to forgive one another. Hallelujah. The New Testament reading is from 1 Thessalonians 5. Now we ask you, brothers and sisters, to appreciate those who diligently work.
work among you. We ask you to recognize and acknowledge and respect your teachers who are in charge over you and the Lord and who give you guidance and instruction. Live in peace with one another. We earnestly urge you, Jesus, to call out those folks who are out of line. We ask you to encourage the timid, those who may lack spiritual courage. We ask you to help the spiritually weak. Be very patient with everyone, always controlling their temper. See that no one repays another evil with evil, and always seek that which is good for one another and for all people. Rejoice always and delight in your faith. Be unceasing and persistent in prayer. Pray in every situation, no matter what the circumstances, and be thankful and continually give thanks to God, for this is the will of God for you in Christ. Do not submit to or quench the Holy Spirit, but open your heart to fulfill the leading of the Holy Spirit. Do not scorn or reject gifts of prophecy or prophecies. Test all things carefully so you can recognize what is good. Hold firmly to all that is good. This is God's word for us this morning. Thanks be to God. We are now going to hear beautiful music from our wonderful choir. If you want to follow along with the lyrics, it's going to be in the thin little blue hymnal that is scattered around, number 2218.
Thank you.
conversation this week with a man who's struggling with a personal situation, and after sharing his story with me, he ended by saying, well, really, all I can do is just pray. And in the moment, I thought, all you can do is just pray? Almost said like a throwaway, like a last resort. All I can do is pray. And it got me to thinking, in light of the stressors of this week, stressors happening not only with war and conflict, but stressors in our own neighborhoods, in our own homes, in our own situations, pressures and challenges that we face. It got me to thinking about this. Is prayer a last resort? Is that the last thing that you turn to? I hope not. I hope it's among the first things we turn to. I had a second conversation with someone, and this is truly how God shows me things. I had another conversation completely unrelated to the first, where a person had experienced a devastating personal loss, a death of someone important to them. And I spoke to this person 3 days later, and this person said, it never even occurred to me to pray. This is a believing, professing person. Never even occurred to me. What happens to us that shakes us away from this energy you're experiencing in here now? What happens to us when we get so distracted, or we get so angry or hurt, that we put Jesus off somewhere as a last resort, that we put God over there somewhere? This has been a troubling week. It has stirred up emotions all over the place. Taking a look at the stock market lately? Anybody? Maybe you're having medical challenges, medical issues of your own. It strikes me as my stock market problems are nothing compared to what's happening to persons a world away. The Apostle Paul tells us to pray constantly, pray without ceasing. The music that Dan played for us this morning is an expression of prayer. You've heard it said that prayer doesn't change God, prayer changes us. How true that can be. Some in this room have seen war up close. I have not yet. Feelings of anxiety, news of cyber war in this new age that we're in, financial challenges, the loss of our family. Is that even possible? Thinking about prayer this week, I dug a little bit into the Hebrew, and the word for prayer in Hebrew is Tefillah. It means a time of contemplation, a time of really taking account of one's own life, a time of taking account of one's own actions and choices. It's a time for thanking God first. How often do we open our prayers with, God, please do this for me now? God, I'm sick and tired of. God, here I am again, asking. And we forget to say, thank you for breath. Thank you for a roof over my head. Prayer, the Hebrew says, is laying ourselves bare before God, laying our needs and our concerns and our gratitude before God, and then shutting it. Shut it. And listen. And listen. See, sometimes listening for God and listening for a word from God can actually be a feeling, right? We can feel a direction. We can feel the Holy Spirit working in us and pushing us in a certain direction. empowering for us to pray for everything. Well, my little prayers are going to help stop that tyrant from doing what he's doing. Really? I don't know that to be true. Maybe all it takes is one more prayer. I don't know how that scorecard works in God's kingdom. Not that he has a scorecard, but you know what I mean. The scripture tells us to not ever meet evil with evil. This is hard for us. This is hard when someone is coming after your kids or someone is threatening your home. This is hard when we see such evil and devastation happening in the world. Do not be evil with evil, but what do we do, really, when those things are happening to us and those feelings are happening inside of us? And what may we be called upon to do? I don't know the answer to that, but what I do know, or right now, for right this minute, is that today we have power to pray. And we have power to ask for God's hand to intervene in a situation where it seems like there is no way. Our God makes a way when there is no way. It's happened in your life. It's happened in my life. And it can happen again. The word for peace in Hebrew is what?
Shalom.
Shalom. It is an ancient word, and translated more literally, it means to be whole and complete. Peace, the peace of shalom deep inside of us. You see, we cannot disperse or emanate or exemplify peace if we don't have it. You can't give what you don't have, right? And if we get caught in that spin cycle, worry and anxiety, and we go round and round and round, and we whip ourselves up into this place of despair, and then we pray for peace. It begins inside of each one of us. It begins in us. And when we are intentional about allowing that to anchor inside of us, God's love, the Holy Spirit's love, the direction of Jesus. That's empowering to us, to persons around us, and ultimately to the world. You've heard this expression, no one can do everything, but everyone can do something. You and I alone cannot do everything, and we're not supposed to do everything. But each and every one of us absolutely can do something. We can do something. And how we focus our attention and our precious time is of powerful importance right now, today and every day, and perhaps now more so than ever. We're just coming off of this 1-2 punch of this nightmare from hell virus that's been permeating our lives for how many years. What can we do today? For starters, number one, abandon a need to try to do everything. You can't, and you're not supposed to. Abandon a need to do anything perfectly. Any perfection seekers in the room? I see you out there. Abandon the need to be perfect. Well, if I don't do this perfectly, then something terrible will happen. Open your eyes, my friends. Open your eyes and your hearts right now and embrace a new spiritual focus in your life today. I'm too old for that. Are you kidding me? I've been doing this way for years. You're not going to tell me what to do. You're right, I'm not going to tell you what to do, and I'll never tell you what to do. But I can tell you what not to do. Last week I spoke here about not giving advice without being asked. Anybody succeed with that? Anybody? Oh, see, I love you all. So, till Monday. Refocus today, my friends. Open your eyes and your heart. Listen to these words from teacher Richard Rohr. This is brilliant. Spirituality is about being ready. All of the spiritual disciplines of your life, prayer, reading scripture, meditation, the rituals that we do, all of them are there so you can break through to the eternal, to the divine. Spirituality is about awakening the eyes and the ears and your heart so you can see what's happening right in front of you. Ouch. That one dug deep inside of me. Because all the intellect in the world doesn't mean anything if you have a hard heart. No one can do everything, everyone can do something, and I'm going to end this message with a piece of music. You have an insert in your bulletin. And listen to this message from the musician John Wilson and take to heart, please, the importance of your role in this world. If anyone does not have an insert with the lyrics, can you raise your hand, because I may need people. Oh, we need to share, please. Can you all look around and share, or if they need to have lyrics shared? We need to share lyrics, please. Lyrics, sharing. One more, we need to share one more over here.
Two more.
Does someone have one they can spare? There, you need one? One more? Can we spare one more? Thanks, here's one. Lorna has one. Thank you. And you bear with me now while I play this piece of music.
Thank you.
said that's also a great case for a treadmill. If you want to put that in your that's one of my favorite go-tos on a treadmill. This is our time in service where we lift up our joys and concerns, and prayers that we share, celebrations. I'm going to start out with a celebration of our dear beloved Jack Westlake, who is home. For visitors and new friends, Jack is one of our amazing foundational people of this church, and he was out sick last week and he is doing better today, so we're very happy about that. Other than the obvious, of course, the situation in Ukraine, anyone need prayers? Dolores?
Margo?
Yes.
My mother, who is having surgery this week.
What's her first name?
Jean.
God, we ask that you would bless men and women and families of our military who put themselves in harm's way every day so that we may sit here on a Sunday morning and sing praises to your name. God, the situation in Ukraine and in other parts of the world where there is conflict, we ask that your hand would intervene. We ask that there would be peace and healing. Lord, we ask that you would touch all of those hearts and minds for folks who have prayers inside of them that they did not share this morning, perhaps too timid or fearful, that you would hear those prayers left unspoken. We ask that your hand would be on Jack for continued healing. We ask that you would be with Margo and Jackie and Bob. We ask for blessings and continued care for Robert, for Kimberly, for Rob, Annie, and Loretta. God, you know the situation that is happening for Carol Ann, and we ask that you would be with her, that you would strengthen her. We ask for a healthy and safe pregnancy for a new baby on the way. We ask that your hand will be on Stephen, the Preston family, as they mourn, to be with Albert, Faith, and Tom. God, please touch Jean and Peg, Allison, and Michael. We ask that you would comfort a grieving family for Evelyn's folks, that you would be with Emily. God, we ask that you would work in the hearts of the unsaved, that they would come to open their hearts in a new way to you, and that we might be good representatives of your love to them. God, we ask that you would be with Norma, that you would help her and heal her, and God, we are thrilled and delighted that dear Janice is back with us today. All of these things, God, we come to you bringing our hearts wide open, saying the prayer that Jesus taught us, our Father, who art in heaven.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
This is the time in our service where we are grateful to receive your gifts and offerings for the continued work of this church, inside and outside the walls.
Thank you. generous love, we bring our gifts with grateful hearts, for we have received so much through your kindness. Bless our gifts and use them to touch lives and situations we cannot even imagine with your love. Make us a blessing in our community for the sake of Christ, our friend and Savior. In his name we pray. Amen.
The lyrics for our final hymn are printed in your bulletin, and please sing it so they can hear it in St. Petersburg. Praise God. Have a blessed week.